In this last video of the number tutorial, we're going to look at two different real-world examples of using number that I have encountered by working as a computational scientist in astrophysics. So the first one is the 3_number group by pixels.ipmb notebook. So here we are doing a pretty straightforward operation. So we are doing a group by operation. So we have a panda series, which is like a NumPy array, but has an index. So instead of having just some values, also have another column, which is the index of those values. And in this case, the index is a unique identifier of a direction in the sky where your instrument is looking. And so let's say that you want to sum all the measurements that you did at a specific point in the sky, and you can do that with a group by operation. You specify level equals zero, that means group by the index. So all the values in this array that point that are associated to a specific direction of on the sky are summed over. And this is pretty slow, so this is not a huge array and already takes a second. And so we want to optimize that with number. So the first step is we create a pure Python function. And so we do a for loop, and then we accumulate on our output array all the different measurements. And of course, being a large loop in pure Python is quite slow, but it works fine. But that's our starting point for number. So we get that function. We have tested it in pure Python, so that's pretty useful to first test it in pure Python, maybe on a subset of the data, if your data is too large. And then once you know that it's working, then you can optimize it with number and use it with number. And so you see here that we notice the impact of compilation. So the first time we run it takes 200 milliseconds, the second time only 70, okay? So that's something you always need to be careful about. And the same thing we can achieve by just using the decorator, okay? Then I am the developer of a Python package, which is called the PySM. Stands for Python Sky Model. It's used in the CMB field and is the first quite large project where I have used number. And I wanted to show you an example on a couple of files in that repository. So you see here, we have a standard Python class, which is implementing a power law model. And we want to integrate the emission of this over a range of frequency. So you see here, all of this is pure Python. And I am optimizing the inner loop. So basically, everything else is not very computationally intensive. I don't need to optimize. But the inner loop, where I am actually taking some number of frequency that can be 10 or can be 100, and then I have complicated power law model, I optimize it with number. So you see a shortcut for doing the no Python is, instead of using the JIT, is to use the NJIT, which is the same thing, but has no Python equal true automatically. And so now this is number. So now this is optimized. And here I can do the integration on the fly. So you see here inside this loop over the different components, the frequencies and the weights, I am doing a step of the trapezoidal integration rule. And so I've implemented, I couldn't use the NumPy trap z function because I needed to be able to run one step at a time and accumulate that so that I don't use too much memory. And so I have this implementation, which is also ngit, which is called by that function, and implements one step of the trapezoidal rule. And you see that this is not parallel, because we don't want to parallelize at this level, while this one is parallelized. So Namba is going to try as much as it can to use multiple threads with this computation. Thank you.